Hey, it's Matt from HowToMotorcycleRepair.com. In front of me here, I have a shock off a 2001 KX250, and in today's video, we're going to rebuild it. I also have a video on how to remove the shock, so if you need to get to this point, definitely check that video out. I found a KYB rebuild kit, which comes with a new bumper, the seals, a new bladder, and whatnot. So, we have that, and also I picked up some 3-weight Maxima shock fluid. And for this video, I'm definitely going to be wearing my safety glasses. We're going to be releasing some nitrogen from the system, as well as there's a bunch of circlips in here. So definitely protect your eyes, wear some gloves, and let's get started. All right, the first step is to remove the cap here. And I'm going to have a magnetic tray here so I can put all my parts in. Just go ahead and depress this valve in here. I'm going to use a screwdriver instead. And I'm just going to take the core out. Alright, next step is to remove the spring. And I already busted this loose on the bike. So just go ahead and spin that all the way up. Alright, and take a quick measurement from the center of the shock bolt to the top of the second ring. I have about 4 inches there, just to get you in the ballpark for... Turns out I have a spanner wrench. Let's see if this will work. Get this ring out here. Slide that out. You can take the spring out. And the ground end goes towards the spanner. Alright, I'm going to crack this bleeder bolt loose. All Alright, and there's an O-ring on there, so don't lose that. Or actually, we'll be replacing it, but just so you know. Alright, you can just pump the, man, that fluid looks nasty. Nice and gray. Just set that aside. Let's put this back in the vise. Alright, next step is to depress this cap in here a little bit. So I'm just going to put something over the Schrader valve here to protect it. And a little more fluid's going to come out, so make sure you have a rag handy. Alright, so what that does is it exposes a clip. This thing's caked in mud. So there that is. I'm going to screw this cap back on. And grab this assembly with pliers and wiggle it out. And I have the drain pan handy here on the floor because I think something's going to come out. It's getting caught up, but maybe the screw is really dirty. Alright, same thing over here. We got to remove this cap. Slowly work your way around. Alright, so get a zip tie and see if you can hold this up in place here. Alright, same thing here. We're needing to push this down and there's a circlip in there. So let me see if I can get a better shot of this. Alright, so I got a better setup there. Camera. I'm going to take a screwdriver here, and we're just going to try to pop this cap down. You can see it's moving down, and it exposes this another circlet. Alright, so that's all we need. I can't even see what I'm doing, so don't worry. I know you can't see this. Alright, so hopefully this just comes right out. Alright, so there's definitely, it was peened over, so we gotta grind it down. Alright, so for all this, you definitely want to take this all off, and to keep its orientation, you know, there's a valve stack on here and everything. So I'm just putting this little by little onto my zip tie here. So you definitely want to retain all that. Alright, remove the seal head. Alright, so there are all the parts. What I'm going to do is wash everything in the parts washer. That's it for me tonight. I broke it all down. That's good enough. Stay tuned. Alright, time to rebuild the seal head. So I'm just going to put it in the vise here. Lightly. This part here, this black seal here, does not come in the kit. So I'm going to very carefully pry it out and hopefully I can reuse it. Use a bunch of silicone spray, so hopefully it'll just slide right out. Alright, take this washer out. The seal came in the kit, so we can replace that. And it's a flat side down. Another washer. And then we got to replace that bushing, O-ring, and then this seal here. All right, so I'm going to loosely put this in the vise. Again, I have aluminum protection here, and I'm just going to snug it up a little bit. See if I can pop this guy off. Wow, that flew right in the garbage. How about that? Alright, looks like a Craftsman 7/16 chrome socket just fits in there. Hopefully it's enough meat too. To budge this bearing here. Apply a little heat to hopefully expand this aluminum and it'll release the bushing. Alright, so the heat definitely helped. So I'm going to let this cool for a while. I'm going to clean it up and then we'll begin reassembly. Alright, let's go ahead and reinstall the new bearing. And what I'm going to be using is a half inch, and I'm going to be using the end with the drive to get a more of a flat surface on the bearing here. So just like that. I'm going to go up to something a little larger. Okay, we're almost there. Same thing, I'm going to add a little heat. Just don't want to damage the bearing. See if that helps. So it has a little further to go. Let's put the washer in. As long as the washer's flat, we're good. Dropping the new seal. Followed by this washer, flat side down. And then this guy here. Alright, time to put this guy back on. And find a socket that'll work with this. Alright, so that's pretty much it. Just bang that on there. Put a little silicone spray on your new O-ring here. That's it. That's how you rebuild a seal head. So I've cleaned up all the parts in my parts washer, and I popped off the old bladder here. It just pops right off, so we can put the new one back on just by I'm going to use a little silicone spray. And something I should have done when I was removing, and the reason I was grinding this is that the nut was peened over so it doesn't come off. So once we grind it off, when we reassemble it, we'll use Loctite. But something I should have done is probably packed it with grease so no metal shavings go down there. So I was took a little extra time to clean that out. So make sure you get all the shavings out of there. So let's go ahead and click this all the way to the softest setting. And that was setting number 10. So this is all clean. We can put our new bumper on. Came with the kit. Just make sure it fully bottoms, you can see it in there. Alright, slide this on. And then we're going to zip tie that in place so it doesn't bother us in the future. Alright, got our rebuilt seal head. This thing is clean, the body's clean. Let's go ahead and put this at the softest setting too. Alright, that was number 7. So just put that aside. Alright, so the next thing is this wear band on the piston, and there's two O-rings underneath it. Now, there is a special tool to install this, which slightly expands it, gets it on there, and then there's another tool that'll compress it. I have neither, so I'm just going to try to work it on very carefully, and then I'm going to wrap it with electrical tape to try to compress it down. So let me go ahead and move this. Remove the valve stack shim here. Definitely don't want to mess this part up. Okay, you want to note here which side's up. It's a little different. So I'm going to actually get a paint marker and just dab it. Just going to dab one of the shims, dab the piston, those go together. Alright, so to cut this out, I guess I'm just going to try an X-Acto knife here. Alright, so you can just cut that right off. Let's get the O-rings out. So that's the top. You can see there's four little cross marks that are a little different from those marks. So the skinny ones go towards the top, towards the body. You can see I rolled the O-rings on there and just make sure they're good. Alright, so this band. Alright, I'm going to get my heat gun out. We're going to slightly heat it and just kind of work it over. Alright, so I got my heat gun here on a low setting. Just gonna try to get this guy a little more pliable. Keeping my distance, I don't know how much heat this thing can take. It's to the point where I can't even touch it, so it's getting pretty hot. Just gonna work some shock fluid on there. Well, that was horrible. Alright, so I have it mounted in a vise here. And what I did is I put some electrical tape right here and built it to almost the same diameter as the shaft. And I had a little bit, there's a chamfer here, and I just covered it, just covered the leading edge of the chamfer here, so I got a nice smooth surface here, and I won't tear, hopefully I won't tear any seals. So I'm gonna put a little shock fluid on here. Put a little shock fluid on the seal head. And then hopefully this sucker will just slide right on. Alright, so that feels pretty good. Let's take this tape off. So I went around about 8 times there. Alright, so let's put this stuff back on here. Followed by the piston, and make sure you match up which way it goes. Alright, so put on some Loctite 272, which is a high strength. I'm actually going to put it on in a more horizontal position here. Okay, put your nut on. Tighten to 25 foot-pounds. Alright, now I'm going to let it cure for 24 hours before I assemble it into the shock and add oil, because I want it to fully cure. Alright, so now with the assembly all back together, I want to compress the wear band. Again, there's a special tool to put it on and a special tool to size it, which I don't have. But what I'm going to do is wrap it very tightly with electrical tape to help compress that band back to size. So I'm just going to go around once to just get the tape going, and then really tightly just wrap it. Pull it to where the tape will almost tear. Alright, and you're going to want to go around about 20 times and just let it sit and come back in 15-20 minutes or so, or overnight or whatever, and then just go ahead and remove the tape. And I already did this step because I want to show you how it fits. So basically this band is really tight, there's no way it's going to come off, and everything feels pretty smooth here all the way around. And I'm just going to check the fit in the body here. And it's dry right now. There's no lubricant. So just give it a wiggle. So it feels nice and tight. Again, there's no lubricant on it, so that's okay for now. So now we're ready to fill it up with fluid and begin reassembly. Oh, one more thing. Let's put this bleeder bolt back in. So my O-ring's in good condition, so I'm just gonna just go with it. There's a little bit of shock fluid on there, so it'll keep it from tearing. Alright, so put your safety glasses on. We're going to be dealing with a circlip. And just in case any fluid splashes, you want to get that stuff in your eyes. Alright, so what I'm going to do is fill it to about 1 inch below the top here. I got a rag here because some oil is going to spill out. I mean, that's the point. You want to fill all the voids. Looks like I got way too much fluid in there. And I got this handy syringe here, so let's just suck some of it out. You can use a turkey baster too. This thing's just garbage. I'm just gonna pour it in the other. Reservoir, since that's next. Alright, let's see where we're at. Alright, I'm just gonna let it spill out. As you can see, that's quite a bit. Son of a... Alright, go ahead and reinstall the circlip. just going to rotate it slightly to make sure it's fully seated. Pull this assembly up. So same thing here, I'm gonna just pour the fluid in till I'm an inch below the surface. I'm just going to drop this in slowly. Now, before I do that, I'm going to fill this bladder up a little bit to expand it so I can just so you can see some oil just squirted out of there. I just wanted to fill that bladder up. Syringe sucks. Just sick of making a mess here. Alright, let's drop this down. I'm just going to go up and down a few times with this. Push down really fast. Hear that noise, the sucking noise? I gotta do it over again. So I pulled it out too far in the Alright, I'm gonna leave it for a few minutes. I can see that there's some air bubbles here, and I just want to give it a few minutes to settle. Alright, let's I'm going to lube up the O-ring here a little bit. Let's drop the seal head down. Fluid's coming out, so that's good. Get a nice tight seal here. And I'm going to depress the bladder here, let the air out. I'm just going to take this valve core out to help it. See, I made the mistake, I put it in the first groove, and there's actually two grooves. So I probably introduced a little bit of air into the system by doing that. Alright, that's definitely in the groove. Bleed it. Alright, so I have it mounted like this, and the manual calls for opening up the bleeder screw and using a suitable container. Well, fluid's just. They say to let it overflow. So I'll let it do that. Get some ketchup. So I'm going to use this syringe. I'm just going to drop it in here. I'm going to fill it up a little bit. I really don't know what they meant in the manual, but let's just say I have this, and if I purge any air, it'll just burp through here. So that's what I'm going to do. Just push this in and out. Not feeling any air in the actual rod. Feels very fluid. And I'm turning it quarter turn here and there. Alright, so it's completely topped off. I'm just going to go ahead and put the leader screw back in. I'm just going to cycle it a few more times, see how it feels. Stop bracket back in. Alright, I'm gonna push it all the way in. Let's put the core back in. Put some air in it. This chuck doesn't work too well here. You can see that it's extending, so that's good. Just gonna pour a little silicone fluid in here to see if it's leaking. Alright, no leaks out of the valve, so that's good. Alright, that's it for now. I'm going to go get this charged with nitrogen. I'm going to leave the spring off so the guy at the shop can double check my work. But for now, that's pretty much it. Okay, so I got the shock filled with nitrogen, put 142 PSI in it. I had to do that at the local shop. And basically what you want to do is compress it and make sure it fully extends on its own. So I'm just going to So everything looks good so far. We can redo the rebound here. So I'm going to go 7 turns from fully soft, which is 12 clicks from clockwise. Alright, this high speed compression, I don't think we messed with, but I want to make sure I have it at a stock setting. Alright, and the stock setting is 1.5 out. So that's 1.5. All right, so I'm at the softest settings, and it's 9 to get to the 10 clicks from the hardest or clockwise. Alright, let's put the spring back on. Alright, the spanner nuts are still all the way down. Slide the flat side of the spring down. Actually, looks like it's the same, both sides. Alright, this part goes first. Bumper out of the way. Just put the bumper back up. And I believe my original measurement was 4 inches from the center of the eye. And that's just rough, because I need to, you know, set my right sag and everything. So at least I'll leave it to where it was and where it worked. And I'll just readjust it. and I'll just leave that loose for now. Alright, so this thing's ready to go back into the bike.